The season of 1980 featured three running backs who were legitimate Heisman Trophy candidates. George Rogers, a senior from the University of South Carolina. Marcus Allen, a junior from the University of Southern California. And a surprising freshman from Georgia, Herschel Walker. A total unknown before the season started, he ran for 1,616 yards to break the all-time freshman rushing record set by Pittsburgh's Tony Dorsett. Against Vanderbilt, Walker broke loose for 283 yards on 23 carries to shatter Charlie Trippi's 35-year-old Georgia single-game rushing record. Walker had four games in which he rushed for more than 200 yards. At 6'2", 220 pounds, he was almost the exact same size as Rogers, and like Rogers, a tireless worker. Slightly smaller, but every bit as effective, was Marcus Allen, who averaged just over 156 yards per game, five less than Rogers, but almost 10 yards per game more than Walker. Like Rogers, he scored 14 touchdowns, one less than Walker, but led the nation with 179.4 all-purpose yards per game. Rogers capped his four-year career with 1,781 yards and a 6-yard-per-carry average, and had some big games against some tough defensive teams, rushing for 142 yards against Michigan, 141 against Southern Cal, and 168 against Georgia. Although he ran for only 623 yards as a freshman, he wound up fourth on the all-time rushing list with more than 4,900 yards. Georgia coach Vince Dooley, who had Walker on his side, told what it was like to have Rogers on the other side.
You just hope you can slow him down. What does that mean? Well, it's now to the point if you can hold him under 200 yards, you've maybe done a pretty good job.
Ironically, Rogers grew up in Georgia before going to South Carolina to make history.
It's with a great deal of pleasure, of course, that we introduce the 1980 Heisman Memorial Trophy winner. Starting in third place. In third place, we have Herschel Walker, the University of Georgia. In second place, Hugh Green, the University of Pittsburgh. And in first place, George Rogers, the University of South Carolina.
Rogers was the eighth running back in a row to win the Heisman. His string of 20 straight 100-yard games or more rushing set a record, and his 6-yard-per-carry average was just under the record set the year before by Southern Cal's White. Rogers was asked who he would have voted for in the Heisman balloting, and he paid tribute to Pittsburgh's Hugh Green, who finished second in the voting.
Well, I probably voted for Hugh Green.
Why?
Well, because the defensive player never won it, you know, and it would have been a real good, it would been a real credit to his side of the football, you know, if he would have won it.
Rogers had his year in 1980, but the next 2 years would belong to Allen and Walker. As we'll see, the wait was worth it for them. In 1981, Walker, now a sophomore, was listed in the program as having gained 2 pounds to 222. But he still had 9.2 second speed for 100 yards. He rushed for 1,891 yards in 1981, the most yards ever by a sophomore, and an improvement of more than 200 yards over his mark as a freshman. He also boosted his per game average to 171.9, up about 25 yards per game from the year before. He had a banner year, but even so, it palled in comparison to the season turned in by Southern Cal's Allen, now a senior. At Southern California, all Allen did was have the best season statistically for any rushing back in any football division of the NCAA. He was the first 2,000-yard rusher in college history and became a triple champion when he added the scoring and all-purpose running titles. Walker, incidentally, was second in all three categories. Allen's single-season total of 2,342 yards broke Tony Dorsett's record by almost 400 yards. And his per-game average of 212.9 broke the record held by Ed Marinaro. Allen won the Heisman Trophy, the ninth straight running back to do it, and said it was a goal he had for a long time.
The Heisman Trophy is a trophy that I would like to win. It's when I was a little kid, so I saw O.J. Simpson win the award. And from that point on, and I fell in love with SC, and I wanted to win the Heisman Trophy.
Believe it or not, Southern Cal recruited Allen as a defensive back. He played fullback 2 years before moving to tailback. It all came together in 1981, and now it was Walker's turn. In 1982, it wasn't all Herschel Walker. Ernest Anderson of Oklahoma State led the nation in total rushing yards per game and yards per carry. Walker was second in all three categories. Anderson, the first of three great OSU backs during the 1980s, accomplished his heroics despite playing down the stretch with a cracked rib, bruised shoulder, and sprained toe. A flak jacket and special air-filled shoulder pads were standard equipment for him. At Southern Methodist, long-striding Eric Dickerson rushed for 1,617 yards and a 7 yard per carry average, and said frankly, he could do it all.
I can run inside, I can run outside, I can catch the ball, I can do just about anything.
Dickerson finished his four-year career at SMU with 4,450 career yards, a remarkable total when you consider he alternated at running back with Craig James in SMU's Pony Express. Nebraska junior Mike Rozier also boasted a 7 yard average per carry, scoring 15 touchdowns and averaging more than 140 yards per game, although he carried only 242 times in 12 games. But as we'll see, he was a year away from his peak. 1982 was Walker's year. He became the first ever junior to reach 5,000 career rushing yards. He averaged 159.3 yards per game for the season, but that figure would have been 173.2, good enough to win the season's rushing title had he chosen not to play in the opener against Clemson. He played with a fractured thumb and gained only 20 yards, but he won the big award and became the 10th straight running back to do it. It seems he had now accomplished all he had set out to do in college football, because he passed up his final year of eligibility, bowing out on top with the game's highest honor.
It is now a great pleasure to announce the winner of the 1982 Heisman Memorial Trophy from the University of Georgia, Herschel Walker.
Before accepting the trophy, Walker shook hands with his coach, Vince Dooley, and then later spoke about the award.
It's a team award to me, because I don't think without them, nothing can be possible. It's an award that helped me to see that life is still a beautiful thing. It's an award to show that things can happen if you're willing to work.
In 1983, with Walker gone, it appeared there might be a scramble for rushing honors, but it didn't pan out, even though some sophomores, like Bo Jackson of Auburn, made a big splash. Bo ran for more than 1,200 yards and averaged 7.7 yards per carry. Against arch-rival Alabama, he ran for 256 yards, including touchdown runs of 69 and 71 yards. He was big, strong, and a punishing runner. A junior at the Naval Academy, Napoleon McCallum had a big season, rushing for more than 1,500 yards and 10 touchdowns, including one against traditional rival Army. He averaged over 144 yards per game, and his 216.8 all-purpose yards per game was among the best in the nation. But Mike Rozier of Nebraska won the rushing title in a blowout, amassing an awesome 2,148 total yards and 7.8 yards per carry. There was no doubt about the Heisman winner, the 11th straight for rushers.
The winner, the 1983 Heisman Memorial Trophy, from the University of Nebraska, Mr. Mike Rozier.
After winning, Rozier had a kiss for his mother.
It was pretty easy when you have big guys in front of you, 6'9", 280, 290. You know, people think it's, you know, just me doing all the work, but it's not. It takes 22 guys to win a ball game.
We'll be back with more of the great rushing backs of the 1980s.
Tired of the same old boring New Year's Eve house party? This year, take a walk on the wild side. Call your cable operator and party with the king, Howard Stern. Invite Howard into your living room this New Year's Eve on pay-per-view. Or go back to the same old tired house party. Howard Stern's New Year's Eve party, live on pay-per-view.
Find out which one of these girls is a man.
Many have witnessed its awesome power. It is a strategic device of immense importance. It can bring into range an entire
City of Lights, the Las Vegas Bowl. Friday night, only on ESPN.
Take 500 wild Koreans. Two captains dressed to kill. And push. Experience the Battle of the War Wagon. Amazing game. Tomorrow night, only on ESPN.
Juniors dominated the rushing scene in 1984. And for a change, none of them won the Heisman Trophy. But one of the best was Reuben Mays of Washington State, who rushed for more than 1,600 yards, more than 148 per game, and 6.3 yards per carry. He set a single game record with 357 yards against Oregon. Attracting the most attention, however, was Keith Byers of Ohio State, who was 6'2 and 235 pounds and ran the 40 in 4.6 seconds. He became the 11th player in history to win the triple crown of rushing, scoring, and all-purpose running as he led the Buckeyes to the Rose Bowl. He earned the praise of one of his idols, Archie Griffin.
He's a fantastic running back. Keith's got all the tools. He's got size, he's got speed, he's got quickness, agility. He's got it all.
Rival coaches were lavish in their praise of him and his season that produced 22 touchdown runs.
Keith Byers is a great football player, the most dominant football player I've ever seen since I've been in the Big Ten, or maybe the most dominant player I've ever seen since I've been coaching.
Keith Byers, without exception, is the biggest, strongest, fastest running back that I have ever seen. He's a big Bo Jackson by about 20, 25 pounds.
The son of a preacher, Byers in high school led his basketball team to two consecutive state championships and was a member of the 440 relay team that won a state title. The baseball team never won a state championship, but Byers hit 520 and 480 his last 2 years. No wonder football looks easy for him. In 1985, Michigan State sophomore Lorenzo White won the rushing title, running for more than 1,900 yards and a per-game average of more than 173 yards. White's rushing yards were the most ever for a sophomore, breaking Herschel Walker's record set 4 years before. Meanwhile, at the U.S. Navy Academy, redshirted Napoleon McCallum was pleased to be returning as a senior for the 1985 season.
It means a whole lot to me. It's a good team, and I was looking forward for us to go to a bowl game and be a winning team. And it kind of hurt me, and I had a lot of fun here. And I just wanted to come back and do that again.
McCallum became the NCAA's all-time record holder in all-purpose yardage with 7,172. In his senior season, he scored 14 touchdowns and averaged 120 yards per game. Thurman Thomas, a sophomore at Oklahoma State, came on strong to finish fourth in the season's rushing derby with more than 1,500 yards and an average of more than 140 per game. His coach, Pat Jones, said Thomas was much more than just another good running back. He said this sophomore was the team leader.
He's such a great leader for us. He's such a bubbly personality. He means so much more to this football team aside from yards and touchdowns. He's just a great individual.
Thomas averaged more than 5 yards per carry and scored 15 touchdowns. And his best years, obviously, were still to come. But 1985 belonged to Auburn's Bo Jackson. Injured in 1984, he played in only 6 games and gained only 475 yards. But he came back in the 85 season to run for almost 1,800 yards and lead the nation with a 6.4 yard average per carry. He had 4 200 yard games and was the first three-sport letterman in the Southeast Conference in 20 years. He was Auburn's second Heisman Trophy winner in the 51-year history of the award, named for former Auburn coach John Heisman.
This year's winner of the Heisman Memorial Trophy. In the closest vote in the history of this trophy, the winner is, from Auburn University, Bo Jackson.
Bo shakes hands all around, and later his coach, Pat Dye, had this to say about this super athlete who had signed professional contracts in both football and baseball.
He's really been the rock that we built the foundation on, and that Bo's presence gave us a chance against everybody we played.
In 1986, Penn State had an acrobatic lion on the sidelines. and a tough one in its backfield as tailback DJ Dozier became the first player in school history to lead the Nittany Lions in rushing for four straight years, running for 811 yards and 10 touchdowns for the season. Brad Muster of Stanford ran for more than 1,000 yards, and against UCLA, he not only rushed for 183 yards, but also caught four passes for 28 yards and scored two touchdowns. Gaston Green was UCLA's top running back, racking up more than 1,100 yards, 14 touchdowns, and a per-carry average of 5.2 yards. He also averaged more than 113 yards per game. Alabama's Bobby Humphrey gained over 500 yards as a freshman, then stretched his total to more than 1,400 yards as a sophomore. He averaged 6.2 yards per carry. Brent Fulwood of Auburn, overshadowed in previous years by Bo Jackson, averaged a remarkable 8.33 yards per carry in rushing for almost 1,400 yards. Paul Palmer of Temple led the nation in rushing yards with 1,866. He averaged almost 170 yards per game and scored 15 touchdowns. He set a record for all-purpose running with 2,663 yards, and his deeds earned him the second spot in the Heisman Trophy balloting. Palmer got so much attention that he became the most famous athlete in Temple history, moving ahead of Bill Cosby. We'll be back with more great running backs of the 1980s.
It may be too much to handle. It's Mode 7 rig rotation and bone-crushing checks. It's NHL Stanley Cup hockey, part of the Super NES Sports Network, and it's in a league of its own.
My dandruff shampoo is good.
Better try something else. Mine really works.
You'd better try something else, like Selsun Blue. Doctors recommend it more than all leading brands. Selsun Blue, doctor recommended number one.
Hollywood Pictures presents Kurt Russell, Val Kilmer, Dana Delaney, Powers Booth, Michael Biehn, Bill Paxton, Jason Priestley, Sam Elliott, and Charlton Heston. Nothing you've heard about the legend can prepare you for Tombstone. Rated R. Start Saturday, December 25th.
1987. Emmett Smith, University of Florida freshman, bursts onto the scene with 1,341 yards rushing to become only the second freshman in history to lead the Southeast Conference in rushing. He gained only 16 yards in the season opener against Miami, but by the seventh game had passed the 1,000-yard mark. He had a slippery running style and an uncanny ability to break tackles, and only Walker and Dorsett gained more yards as a freshman. Blair Thomas of Penn State had a big year, rushing for more than 1,400 yards and averaging almost 130 yards per game. He scored 11 touchdowns. Lorenzo White of Michigan State was sixth in rushing yards, but he was a consensus All-American. Jamie Morris led Michigan with a 5.7-yard average per carry. Tony Jeffrey of Texas Christian had the best per carry average among the top rushers, posting a 6.7 standard, netting over 1,350 yards for the season and scoring 10 touchdowns. Because of an injury, he played in only 10 games. Craig Ironhead Hayward of Pittsburgh was in the chase for the rushing title, but finished second despite a total of 1,655 yards and a per-game average of 150.45 yards in one of the closest races ever. The title went to Albert Icky Woods of Nevada, Las Vegas, whose season total was just 3 yards more and whose per-game average was less than a foot better. A big part of the 1987 rushing story centered on Thurman Thomas of Oklahoma State. He was one of the best in the nation as a sophomore in 1985 when he ran for more than 1,550 yards. But in 1986, injuries limited him to only 173 carries, as opposed to the year before when he carried 302 times. He had a total of only 741 yards, so he felt he had something to prove when the new season came around. He left no doubts about his stature as one of the premier running backs in the nation. He played in 11 games, carried the ball 250 times for 1,613 yards, and a per-game average of more than 146 yards. He averaged 6.5 yards per carry and became the first player in history to lead Oklahoma State 4 years in rushing. And like the postman, the weather didn't hamper his effectiveness. He belongs among the great running backs of all time. In 1988, there was no clear-cut favorite for the rushing title. There were many good backs, like Anthony Thompson of Indiana, who led the Big Ten with 1,546 yards rushing and more than 140 yards per game. You wouldn't think anybody could make those marks sound puny, but someone did. The fireworks in Stillwater, Oklahoma were caused by Barry Sanders, who, the year before, had played in the shadow of Thurman Thomas. Sanders, an Oklahoma State junior, set an entirely new standard for college running backs. With no preseason buildup, he won the Heisman Trophy and the Maxwell Award. His figures transcended anything ever done in rushing, scoring, and all-purpose running.